Well, I'm tracking Catherine right now, and it looks like she is out of hibernation and really close to the barn back behind me there. Yeah, she's not far away at all. Oh yeah. She might be down here in the creek. There's the incomplete bridge. If you've ever been to Earthshine before, you know how this works. She's down here. There she is. Right here. See her? Here's another look at Catherine. First time we've seen her since back in the fall of 2013. I am going to have to pick her up and weigh her here in a minute, but until that time, I'm gonna leave her alone and do my data collection silently. So I'm gonna turn the camera off for now. Okay, so I've got my hat ready. Got the scale ready. Let's get Catherine. Here she is. Get her in the sun. Hey, Catherine. Yeah, I know you remember me, I'm sure. The guy that's caught you thousands of times over the years. You look really good. I don't see any damage. Active. Okay, let's do this quick. Okay, here we go. Our transmitter looks good. Oh, I know she doesn't like that hat. $655. Just to check it one last time. Yep, $655. That's counting the hat. All right, say goodbye to Catherine. $655 minus $155. Oh, can't get better than that. So she's... she's 555 grams. Now, because this is a brand new field notebook, I can't look back and see what she weighed in the fall and compare, but I can do that later. But I'm sure she's probably not lost very much weight. She feels nice and heavy. She's clamped up tight. Often she'll just take off running, but this time I think she's just decided that, hey, it's that same guy. Maybe she's used to me, I don't know. Adjust her antenna a little bit. All right, that's it for Catherine. Now we need to go find Jimmy. Thank you. That's a pretty picture. Well, seems to be coming from the area around Jimmy's place. Let's check it out. Well, look at that. This year's garden is a blueberry patch. Hibernated just over there to the right of the cover board. May still be in the area. Yep, I think he's up here. Maybe right here. Yeah, I think he is. In this pile of leaves. Let's see for sure. Yep, that's where he is. All right. I'm sure he knows I'm here by now. Sit here and hope I don't get bitten by a copperhead or a rattlesnake or something. That would be really bad. He's here. I would say there's a hole there. Something like a rodent made. But I would bet he's obviously right under this clump. These leaves look a little pushed up. Like he dug down under there and turned around a few times pushing up the leaves. I'm not going to take a look. I'm just going to reach my hand down and see if I can touch his shell. Yep, he's in there. Okay. Before I bring him out, I'm going to collect my data. Then we'll bring him out and weigh him like we did with Catherine and put him back. So in the meantime, I'm going to turn off the camera. Okay, so before I weigh Jimmy, I'm going to have to try to get his shell temperature under the leaves because out here it's incredibly hot. The sun is just blaring down on these leaves and it's around 100 to 110 degrees right here in this area. I mean, I'm probably getting roasted right now. I feel like I am. And I have a sunburn because I haven't really been in the sun all winter. So what I'm going to try to do is just dig down, expose his shell, and take three temperature readings before the sun hits him. There he is. 85.6. 85.2. And 84.2. Here we go. We're going to make this quick. I want to put him back down in there. I don't want him to get too hot. I'm going to check him over. Oh, you look great, Jimmy, as usual. Bright red eyes. A little bit of dirt from hibernation there, probably. Now we're going to weigh him really fast. Sorry, buddy. The hat again. Yeah, I know. All right, Jenny. See you next time. Put him right back down in his form. Cover him up. 620 minus the hat. 468 grams. So he's 85 degrees, whoo, hot turtle. And let's see, 18.2 humidity over there at 5 feet. And the temperature is 100.3. Crazy, it is hot in here. Let's get out of here. Got Jimmy's data, boiling hot, boiling hot. I've buried him back down in the leaves. And we're going to go find Zoe now. All right, so I'm heading into the woods to find Zoe now. And it is such a hot day. What I wouldn't give to find just a random sink in the middle of the forest. Oh, wait. Look at this. A random sink in the middle of the forest. Cool. I wonder if there's any water here. No water from that one. Oh, look at there, water. I guess I could wash my face, huh? This is awesome. Yeah, what do you think of that? Oh, that's nice. It's good water, too. So what are the odds of finding a random sink in the middle of the forest? I'd say pretty good around here. Let's find that snake. Ah, she's that way. Yep. Sounds like she's up above the waterfall. All right. Sounds to me like she's down in the field. Ooh, getting a little louder now. Aha! A place she's been before, I believe. Well, I have found her in this area before. Very close to here. In fact, just over there, about 30 feet away in those bushes. I can't see her. Well, maybe I'll be able to get around this impenetrable mass of thorns. Let's see. It seems that she's straight through the wall of thorns. I found her laying in these briars one time, not 15 feet from where I'm standing now, but the signal is much stronger in that direction, near the big tree. Somewhere directly in front of me, I believe. Let me check behind me just in case. Nothing there. Yep, she's in this tangle of multiflora rose. And there's no way I'm gonna be able to find her. It's just impenetrable. I'm looking to see if I can see any pattern of her markings right in front of me, but I see nothing. So that tells me she's a good distance over in there. probably at least 20 feet. And there's really no way to go in there and find her. And I wouldn't want to anyway, because it would disturb her and it would damage her habitat. So sometimes you just have to say no, that you're not going to proceed any further in order to protect the animal and its habitat. Okay, so what I'm going to do is the same thing I do whenever I find one of the animals and I can't actually see it visually. I'll take down temperature, humidity, and a waypoint to give me at least some climate data, and then distance from the last known location. So let's do it. Okay, so Zoe has traveled 0.2 miles to the southwest from her day 71 location. And that's a good distance. But what's even more interesting is that, let me see if I get these numbers right. She's only 50 feet northwest of her day 28 location and 100 feet south of her day 27 location. So that tells me that there's something very important about this spot to Zoe. So again, another reason for habitat protection of wildlife. They go to the places that they go to for reasons known only to them. And if we destroy these areas, they won't have a home. It's that simple. So that's it for Zoe for today. And let's head out of the woods, and we'll be back in a week to check on the reptiles.